Introduction. AudioLearn's Medical School Crash Courses presents Preventive Medicine. Written by experienced professors and professionally narrated for easy listening, this crash course is a valuable tool both during school and when preparing for the USMLE, or if you're simply interested in the subject of preventive medicine. The audio is focused and high yield, covering the most important topics you might expect to learn in a typical medical school preventive medicine course. Included are both capsule and detailed explanations of critical issues and topics you must know to master preventive medicine. The material is accurate, up-to-date, and broken down into bite-sized sections. There are key takeaways following each chapter to drive home key points and quizzes to review commonly tested questions. In this course, we'll cover the following topics. What is preventive medicine? Epidemiology of disease. Primary health care and levels of prevention. Mental illness prevention. Cancer prevention. Heart disease prevention. Infectious disease prevention. Injury prevention. Diabetes prevention. Substance use prevention. Violence prevention. Prevention in pregnancy. And aviation medicine. We will conclude the course with a comprehensive test containing the most commonly tested questions in preventive medicine with the correct answers. To get the most out of this course, we recommend that you listen to the entire audio once while taking notes, then go back and listen to areas you had difficulties with. AudioLearn's Medical School Crash Courses support your studies, help with USMLE preparation, and provide a comprehensive audio review of the topic matter for anyone interested in what medical students are taught in a typical medical school preventive medicine course. Now, let's get started. Preface. This course examines the topics important to preventive medicine. The goal of preventive medicine is to avoid disease, either by preventing it altogether or by stopping the disease progression before serious complications or death occurs. Preventive medicine can be a public health issue on the part of governmental agencies, an issue dealt with by the primary care physician, or by the individuals themselves. Some of the challenges of preventive medicine include changing policies, identifying ways to prevent disease, and motivating individuals to make positive changes in their lives. As you will see, many of the challenges directly involve the primary care provider. The subject of Chapter 1 of the course is the scope of preventive medicine in today's culture. Preventive medicine is different from curative medicine because the aim is to achieve the absence of disease rather than to treat disease. In reality, there are several levels of prevention, some of which aim to decrease the complications of diseases already present. There are personal, professional, and public health aspects to preventive medicine that will be discussed as part of this chapter. Chapter 2 in the course is about the basic science of preventive medicine, which is epidemiology. This is the study of the who, what, where, when, and why of disease processes in medicine. This is how professionals understand which diseases are prevalent and make assessments of the causation of the disease process. A great deal of money and effort is spent on epidemiology of disease, so that policies can be made about those things that have become a public health crisis or have a known way of preventing it. Chapter 3 in the course looks at ways that primary health care can help in prevention of disease. The primary doctor starts with annual physical examinations, which look at the range of preventable diseases and aims to prevent as many as possible. Screening tests are a big part of disease prevention. There are dozens of preventive screening tests that can detect disease either before it occurs or in its earlier stages, where it is most treatable. This chapter also talks about levels of prevention, which are the different ways that adverse disease outcomes are deflected. The focus of Chapter 4 is the prevention of mental illness. This includes personal intervention, such as seen in suicide prevention, as well as global interventions, such as those outlined for whole populations by the World Health Organization, or WHO. The prevention of mental illness can be done in schools as well. Each of these can have a major impact on mental health outcomes and can have a lasting impression on overall health. Chapter 5 in the course examines the prevention of various kinds of cancer. Not all cancers are preventable, but several have good preventive strategies. Remember that for many cancers, there is primary prevention, to prevent the cancer from occurring in the first place, and secondary prevention, to detect cancer at an early stage. The secondary prevention of cancer, which is the screening part, has already been covered. This chapter will look at primary preventive strategies for different types of cancer. The topic of Chapter 6 is heart disease prevention. Prevention of heart disease involves the assessment of all of the risk factors in the patient and acting on the risk factors in order to prevent their cardiovascular complications. Things like hypertension, obesity, exercise, and lipid levels can each be managed in order to create a cardiovascular risk profile that is improved from the baseline. Aspirin is a common preventive drug used in the prevention of heart disease, and this will be discussed in the chapter. Chapter 7 in the course discusses infectious disease prevention. The most commonly used form of infectious disease prevention is through immunizations, which are the classical forms of primary prevention. There are prevention strategies for Lyme disease, the different forms of hepatitis, and sexually transmitted diseases besides immunizations. Post-exposure prophylaxis is available for some infectious diseases, most notably for HIV/AIDS. Each of these topics will be covered in this chapter. The focus of Chapter 8 in the course is injury prevention. This is a widely reaching topic that involves all types of potential injuries. Injury prevention in children involves the proper use of child safety gear in motor vehicles and playground safety. Falls are a common injury in the elderly, which can be prevented to some degree. There is a wide range of topics related to traffic safety, from road traffic safety to pedestrian safety to motorcycle and bicycle safety. Occupation injuries are also covered in this chapter, along with ways they can be prevented. Chapter 9 examines diabetes, and in particular, the primary and secondary prevention of diabetes. Diabetes is a serious chronic disease that can go unnoticed for many years without adequate secondary prevention and screening efforts. Because of the explosion of diabetes in developed countries, primary prevention has become a topic of research and public health efforts because this is a disease that can be prevented entirely with proper attention paid to the risk factors. The subject of Chapter 10 in the course is substance use prevention. There are primary and secondary preventive efforts that can be used to decrease the use of substances, such as tobacco, alcohol, and illicit drugs. Much of the primary prevention focuses on preventing youth from taking up tobacco and illicit substances at all, and to wait until they are of a legal age to drink. There is use and abuse of some substances, with preventive efforts directed at decreasing the rates of abuse. Chapter 11 in the course examines violence prevention. Violence can affect individuals from infancy to old age and comes in many forms, including child abuse, sexual violence, firearm injuries, and intimate partner or domestic violence. There are many programs designed with violence prevention in mind, focusing on all areas of potential violence. These are necessary as those who survive violence can suffer from many mental, emotional, and physical sequelae for the duration of their lives. The focus of Chapter 12 is prevention related to pregnancy. Primary prevention of teen pregnancies is an important part of this. When women intend to get pregnant, there are some things they can do to prevent pregnancy-related complications before they get pregnant. The vast majority of prenatal care involves prevention of gestational complications. Infectious disease in pregnancy is a particular area of concern when it comes to prevention. Substance use disorder in pregnancy often needs secondary prevention efforts. Chapter 13 in the course covers aviation medicine, also referred to as aerospace medicine or space medicine. It is a subcategory of preventive medicine involved in the preventive measures designed to help those who fly airplanes and space shuttles stay safe. There are mental and physiological stressors involved with flying that are unique to the job. The scope of practice when it comes to safety is covered in this chapter. Chapter 1. What is preventive medicine? The subject of this chapter is the scope of preventive medicine in today's culture. Preventive medicine is different from curative medicine because the aim is to achieve the absence of disease rather than to treat disease. In reality, there are several levels of prevention, some of which aim to decrease the complications of diseases already present. There are personal, professional...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.